Have you heard that new construction in Fort Mill, South Carolina is booming? Have you heard that Fort Mill, a suburb of Charlotte, North Carolina, is booming in general? Well, that's what I'm talking about today, and I'm gonna kick it into gear right now. My name is Eli Maggins, and I'm a real estate advisor here in Charlotte, North Carolina, and the surrounding areas of South Carolina. And I specialize in luxury homes and new home construction. But more importantly, I am your realtor with heart. I'm not trying to sell you a house. I'm here to help you find a home and a lifestyle that you and your family are going to love. If you think that you and I are a good fit, I would love to hear from you, and I would love to help you create the next best part of your life. My contact information is down below. Now, I know an awful lot about Charlotte, its real estate, and everything surrounding Charlotte, and I put out videos every single week. Don't want you to miss any of those, so I'd love you to go down to the red subscribe button, hit the red button, hit the bell, and you'll be notified when my great, awesome videos are out every single week. And I would love for you to stay tuned to the very end of this video, because I'm gonna give you a free online guide that's gonna tell you everything about Charlotte, the surrounding areas and neighborhoods, the schools. It's yours for free, but you've gotta stay tuned to the very end. So today I'm taking you to a new construction luxury neighborhood in Fort Mill called the Enclave at Massey. The Enclave at Massey is located on a road called Dobie's Bridge. It is right over the Charlotte borderline in Fort Mill. So the location is so convenient to Charlotte, you can take advantage of everything that Charlotte has to offer. It's gonna be about 25 to 30 minutes to the airport, 25 to 30 minutes to Uptown Charlotte. So you've got a phenomenal location. Now Massey, right across the street from Enclave at Massey, is a massive, huge, humongous neighborhood with many, many homes. The Enclave at Massey is a much smaller, much more intimate type of neighborhood, and in my opinion, seems a bit more luxurious. Now, the two do share an amenity center, which has a clubhouse, a fitness center, a pool, and a splash park. But the amenities are on the Massey side. The Enclave at Massey is quieter. The one good thing about Massey and the Enclave at Massey sharing the amenity center is that there are so many homes in Massey that the HOA fees in the Enclave at Massey are very small in comparison to the size of the neighborhood if it were to have its own pool and clubhouse. Now, the builder of the Enclave at Massey is a semi-custom home builder called Shea Homes. Shea Homes has neighborhoods all throughout the Charlotte area and actually throughout the entire country. They are semi-custom so that they can add and take away certain things that other home builders cannot do. There's more flexibility with Shea Homes than, let's say, a Lennar or a Pulte. Like I said, Shea is semi-custom. Now, Shea Builders also builds in North Carolina in two very popular neighborhoods, one in Weddington and one in Marvin. Both of them have no more lots, and they are scrambling to develop whatever land they have left so that they can sell the lots that are remaining. And the one thing about those neighborhoods in Weddington and in Marvin, built by Shea Homes, starting point of those homes are $900,000. Figure anywhere from $900,000 to about $1.2 million for a home built by Shea in Marvin or in Weddington. Here at the Enclave at Massey, you're getting the same home, the same build, for substantially less money. You can get a brand new home, newly built, from about $550,000 up to about $750,000 for essentially the same product. It's a huge difference. Now you're asking, Eli, why is there such a huge difference in price between Weddington and Marvin and Fort Mill? Essentially, it's the cost of the land. It costs the same to build a house in Weddington as it does to build a house in Fort Mill, but the price of the land in Fort Mill at this particular moment is less expensive than Weddington or Marvin. But that will change with time. The other major difference, other than price, is probably lot size. In Marvin, the same product will probably be on about a half an acre. In Weddington, it will be on something close to 1 acre. And here at the Enclave in Massey and Fort Mill, it's gonna be on something about 1/3 of an acre, maybe a little bit more than 1/3 of an acre. But that's essentially the difference. The homes are the same, same builder, same quality, same luxury. So Fort Mill right now is booming, and you're asking, how are the schools in Fort Mill? Well, a lot of people are moving to the Fort Mill area for the schools. In fact, the area is booming so much that they have just built a brand new elementary, middle, and high school in the Fort Mill area. This particular neighborhood is zoned for Catawba Ridge High School. You can look those up on greatschools.org. There may not be any rating yet because they're brand new. They were opened only in September, and obviously with this COVID stuff, no one has gone to school. But they are zoned for Catawba Ridge High School, which is a brand new high school. So what about the homes, Eli? Well, the homes are absolutely beautiful. Shea puts out a beautiful product. They are on par with Toll Brothers or even here in Jones Homes. They are semi-custom and they are beautiful. There are 6 or 7 plans that you can choose from. You can change them up here and there because they are semi-custom. You can get a 2-car garage, a 3-car garage, a 4-car garage. You can get a carriage house. Whatever you want, you could probably get it. You can get 4 sides brick. You can get 4 sides painted brick, which is my favorite. You could get stone with siding in the front. There are many elevations to choose from. If you stay away from brick and go with stone and siding, you will probably save yourself about 35 grand, which you can throw into the house for your kitchens and bathrooms and flooring and stuff like that. Many of the homes here are backing up to woods. So you've got trees in the back. You've got beautiful lots. Now there's good news here and there's bad news here. The good news here is they have 4 lots left. As we speak, as of the date of this video, there are 4 lots left, which is good because other neighborhoods have none. So the bad news is that they only have 4 lots left. So if you're raring to go, now would be the time. They do have some more land that they have to start developing, but that will not probably come online as sellable lots for the next 9 or 10 months. So at this point, there are 4 lots left. As I said before, home prices here range anywhere from $550,000 for about 2,850 square feet, up to about $740,000 for about 5,500 square feet. So on average, I would say the average price point here is about $640,000 for a home that's about 4,000 square feet on a minimum of about 1/3 of an acre. It's actually very, very reasonable for the amount of luxury and the location that you're getting in this particular neighborhood. And this neighborhood gives you that bang for the buck, luxury and location. Are you looking for a luxury home here in the Charlotte, North Carolina area? Or are you looking for a new construction home here in the Charlotte, North Carolina area or the surrounding suburbs? Remember, it is so important to find somebody who you like and someone who you trust. If you think that you and I are a good fit, I would love to hear from you and I would love to help you get to the next best part of your life. My contact information is down below. Now remember, I put out brand new videos every single week. I'm not sure how I do it, but I do. It's the best that Charlotte has to offer and the surrounding areas of South Carolina as well. So I'd love for you to go down to subscribe, hit the red button, hit the bell. You'll be notified when my new videos are out every single week. And for that free online guide that I told you about, go down to the description below. There's a link there for free community and school guide. Click on that link. Get that guide for free. It's invaluable information. In a couple of seconds, a couple of my other videos will be popping up. It's very similar to this one. Go ahead, check those out. I also have a whole YouTube channel full of stuff about Charlotte and the surrounding areas. But most importantly, I thank you so much for watching. Welcome to the great area of Charlotte, North Carolina, and the surrounding suburbs of South Carolina. And until we see each other again, next time.